We all know Bruckner as a symphony composer. There are these 9 fantastic symphonies, which when I was a child were not terribly well known. And I remember when a great big box set of them came out, conducted by Haitink, who's conducting them this weekend. He was a young man, and he was one of the first really great Bruckner conductors in the second half of the 20th century with the Concertgebouw Orchestra. And so to be doing Bruckner with him is a fantastic privilege, as it were, from the horse's mouth. Bruckner wrote quite a lot of religious music. He was himself a church organist. He was a great believer. And it was absolutely central to his work. So there are a lot of motets that a lot of people know, Locus Dei, Ave Maria, but there are about 20 motets altogether. There are 3 or 4 settings of the Mass, which are done more often than the Te Deum is. And I guess the reason the Te Deum isn't done that often is that it needs 4 soloists, a very well-prepared choir, a big orchestra. It only lasts 20 minutes. And what do you put it with? And the answer is, it's one of those pieces. There are quite a lot of 20-minute pieces by Brahms as well, which are in fact rather useful stocking fillers in a programme if you're going to do a big symphony in the second half. So that's why the symphonic choruses and orchestras can do this repertoire, but you wouldn't find a choral society doing it very often, because what on earth do you do with it? It sounds like a symphony, with words, if you like, and very irritatingly, or wonderfully, he keeps on leaving the orchestra out, leaving the choir singing these great motet-like church music bits. And they have been mighty good, beautifully in tune, beautifully blended and so on, so that the choir sounds glorious. And the sound we need for that is a sound that on the whole English choirs don't naturally make. Our sound is bright and brilliant and absolutely ideal for Belshazzar's Feast, for example, by Walsen. What we need here is a more German sound, Austrian-German sound, which particularly for the tenors, but for everyone, involves using what's called head voice. So there's a lot of a lot of very light sound. So the tenors are not very dominant, even though they're rather high in their voices. And the basses sing very low, and we've got to make sure we put lots of bright overtones on that sound so it doesn't like sound like they're digging their own graves. And there are a lot of very difficult notes, but in the end, what we're now doing is making sure we really know what the text means, why Bruckner says things 3 or 4 times. He gets all the text of the Te Deum, we praise thee, O Lord. A lot of it he just says once and gets out of the way. And then the last phrase, a quarter of the whole piece is on the last phrase, which is clearly the most important to him, that God really is interested in looking after him and making sure that he will be gathered up and come to God. And to get there, we go through an incredibly angular fugue, as if the life that he is leading is not easy and nothing can be taken for granted. And then finally, on the last page, there is the glory of God, and we see God. And I think it's terribly important that we discuss that in the rehearsals, so that we can really put the pictures over and not only sing it correctly. And I guess that's something that I've been very privileged to learn from Simon Rattle and Peter Sellers. Peter Sellers, the great American theatre director, Simon Rattle, our great future chief conductor, to make sure everything is done with real conviction. So I'm hoping that this will absolutely blaze and that people will think, I've never heard that piece before, but I'm very much looking forward to hearing it again.